I've already applied my foundation and my concealer, and I've set both with a lightweight finishing powder. If you're interested in seeing what I use, check out the info box below. I always list it. And if you're interested in seeing how I will fill in my eyebrows, check out my eyebrow routine. It's linked in the info box as well. Now I just applied some Urban Decay Primer Potion in Eden all over my lids and blended it out. And this will keep my shadows lasting all day and looking vibrant. Then I'm taking a matte brown, a medium matte brown, which you can use from just about any palette, and blending this into my crease with Windshield Wiper Motions. This is going to act as a blending color and a really nice just natural crease color. And all the other shadows will be from this quad, and it's by Bare Minerals. It's the Truth Quad. I took the second darkest shade and I deepened the outer third or outer half of my eye before taking a clean blending brush and just blending it out. I am not a fan of harsh lines, so I must take the extra time to blend everything before going to my lid color, which is a light taupey color. I'm just gonna pat that on to my empty lids. Lightest color of the quad is going to act as our inner corner color, and I blend it kind of like into my lid a little bit, like a third into my lid, and it also is our highlight later on. But then I took my blending brush and I took the darkest color and just patted it into my outer corner and blended it in with small, gentle, light-handed strokes. As far as eyeliner goes, nothing too special, just small strokes with my liquid liner into my typical cat eye. I have a video on this as well. Before curling my natural pathetic lashes and applying the nude colored eyeliner by Rimmel to my lower waterline and lash line. Just brighten up my eyes and make everything look just a little bit cleaner. I applied some waterproof mascara to my real lashes before applying some false lashes, which these are the new Velour Wispy Lashes from their Wispy collection, and they are gorgeous. They're tightlining any gaps I had in my eyeliner. I took my fan brush to contour my face with the matte bronzer from the Lorac palette. I really love to contour my face to just add some definition, dimension, and slim down my cheeks, as well as the size of my forehead and a little bit on my jawline. Now that we have our shape, I'm going to apply my blush, which is my favorite blush of all time, Benefit Coralista. It has a gorgeous sheen, so there's no need for a highlighter. That is what you guys have been seeing when I'm wearing this look. It is this blush reflecting light. It's not shimmery, it's more of a satin, and it's gorgeous. It's a nice natural blush that looks good on just about everyone, and it works as a highlighter. So I apply it as both. Then I applied some lip balm, which is some rose salve, before going in with my all-time favorite lipstick. If you've been watching me for a long time, you already know what it is. It's Cherish, which is the perfect neutral color, which you can pair with just about any gloss. I switch it up a lot, but today I'm using the NARS Larger Than Life Gloss in Puri. And it is a gorgeous neutral color and not sticky whatsoever, if you're wondering. And that completes our look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. All the info on all the products will be down below, as well as pricing. And if you're interested in seeing a hair tutorial for the look I am wearing, I will also link it off right where I'm pointing and in the info box. Thank you guys as always for watching. See you later.